Let's now get an update on the weather here in the Philippines from PAGASA forecaster Chanel Dominguez. Chanel, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Rica, and good afternoon to all. So currently, we are monitoring a low-pressure area inside our Philippine area of responsibility, and it was estimated based on all available data at 695 kilometers east of Butuan City, Agusan del Norte, last 3 a.m. This LPA, we are not ruling out to be a tropical cyclone within the next 24 hours and may be named Enteng within the next 24 hours. Due to this low-pressure area, expect a cloudy skies with scattered rains and thunderstorm over Caraga, Davao Region, Northern Mindanao, Sok Sargent, Central Visayas, Lanao del Sur, Maguindanao del Norte, Maguindanao del Sur, Leyte, Southern Leyte, and Eastern Samar. Due to this low-pressure area, which is pulling the southwest monsoon, also expect a cloudy skies with scattered rains and thunderstorm over Palawan and the rest of Mindanao. For Metro Manila and the rest of our country, expect a generally fair weather with high chances of localized thunderstorm during the afternoon and the evening. That's the latest in PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Chanel Dominguez, and good afternoon.
Thank you so much. Chanel Dominguez reporting live from PAGASA. SM Prime Holdings is transforming its malls to adapt to the fast-changing trends and behaviors of consumers. Jackie Pascual tells us what the retail giant has in store for its shoppers.
SM Prime Holdings is renovating its malls to entice more customers amid the rise of online shopping. At the National Retail Conference and Expo, SM Prime Chairman Hans C. said they are adding more restaurants and attractions to improve the mall-going experience.
What we need to do is to adapt. And adapt meaning, instead of expecting people to go to your place to shop, you have to make it experiential for them. Make it interesting for them.
SM Mall of Asia and SM Mega Mall are some of the malls undergoing improvements with wider greenery, more outdoor spaces, and an overall revamping of the interiors. The renovation project will also be implemented in SM's malls in China. C says their business in the mainland remains strong.
Well, it's actually doing well. Contrary to
what people
are talking about, it's actually doing very well. In fact, I find it a lot of evolutions in the business, so it's very challenging. The typical China.
Apart from renovating malls, SM is also conducting the reclamation of 360 hectares of land adjacent to the 60-hectare Mall of Asia complex. It will be a mixed-use business district with the Pasay City government, with Hans C. Sun as one of the project leads. They envision the new property to be a master-planned urban district that will adhere to sustainable practices. About 150 billion pesos is allotted for the reclamation alone, which is expected to be completed by the end of next year.
With what you can see with what we've done with 60 hectares here, we'd love for you to see what we can try to deliver for something that's twice the size of BGC.
It will be developed as a modern city, of course, taking advantage of Mall of Asia, but with other lots of new and interesting shopping ideas into it.
SM Prime recorded 22.1 billion pesos in consolidated net income in the first half of the year, with revenues from its small business accounting for more than half of its total top line. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Fish catch from Manila Bay are now safe to eat, according to the Philippine Fisheries and Aquatic Resources Bureau. This comes after three vessels sank and caused oil spills. The BFAR said all samples of seafood, including fish and shellfish collected on Tuesday, have passed three rounds of tests. Earlier this week, President Marcos also lifted the ban on fishing in parts of Bataan Province. The Philippine Health Department updates its guidelines on Mpox after cases climbed to 14, with the latest, a 12-year-old boy in Batangas. Rafael Bosano reports.
Wala pong granular lockdown, wala pong lockdown sa barangay, wala pong lockdown sa eskwelahan.
This assurance coming from the mayor of the municipality of Balayan, Batangas, following confirmation that the country's 14th case of Mpox hails from the area. The 14th case is a 12-year-old boy. The DOH says the patient developed symptoms last August 10, but it took almost 2 weeks for the patient to consult a rural health unit.
Pinapa-verify lang po namin kung nanggaling siya sa eskwelahan, pero huwag kong kabahan, no, ang mga taga-Balayan, dahil so far wala naman kami nakikitang linkages to that effect. Kasi totoy natin na 12-year-old boy, hindi naman siya naglabas-labas na nung may nakita siyang mga simptomas niya. So we don't think na para bang nagkaroon ng pag-ikot from August 10 to the point na nag-consult siya.
The patient is now recovering. The DOH has earlier said close contacts of an mpox patient need not quarantine as long as they don't have symptoms. But Frando says they have asked close contacts of the 12-year-old patient to limit skin-to-skin contact with others.
Yung po yung kapamilya kasama sa bahay, yung pong nayapusan, nahalikan, yung pong kasamang matulog, at yung pong matagal na kasama sa isang maliit na lugar.
Meanwhile, despite all being from Metro Manila, the DOH does not see the connection between the other four mpox patients. This even if patients 10, 11, and 12 admitted to having sexual activities prior to the onset of their symptoms.
Ang isa sa mga information na nakuha namin is, isa siya non-direct patient care. So taga, ibig sabihin, health worker siya, pero hindi tumitingin ng pasyente. Kailangan i-remind yung mga infection prevention and control precautions pagdating sa ating mga ospital.
The DOH has recently published its updated guidelines on mpox, which they say the public should read to prevent the disease from spreading. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
Researchers from the University of the Philippines have found E. coli bacteria in some vegetables in Metro Manila, including those from urban farms. The Philippine Plant and Industry Bureau, meanwhile, gives advice on how to avoid contamination of fresh produce. Izzy Lee tells us more.
Urban farming became one of city residents' means of survival and livelihood during the COVID-19 lockdowns. But in a study of more than 400 vegetable samples taken from urban farms in four major wet markets in Metro Manila at the height of the pandemic, researchers from the University of the Philippines Diliman College of Science found Escherichia coli or E. coli bacteria in over 13% of the samples. The researchers also observed that E. coli presence was higher in the vegetables taken from urban farms. E. coli is typically found in human and animal waste. The study says animals like dogs, cats, and chickens that roam urban farms increase the risk of microbiological contamination in irrigation water and the soil where vegetables grow. The research aims to improve and develop urban farming practices. Alina, an urban farmer, says she's taking measures to ensure her produce is clean and safe. By keeping her plants away from animals and thoroughly washing her harvest before selling them at the market.
Eh, naano ko yun, binubugaw ko yun. Pinapaalis ko sa taniman, pati mga pusa. Kasi pag minsan eh, doon sila sa yung mga talbos, mga ano na epektuhan din. Ang ginagamitan ko po ng ano, tubig. Sa nawasa po, maganda tingnan lagi ang gulay. Hinuhugasan po namin bago ibinta.
According to the Bureau of Plant Industry, or BPI, there remains a high risk of microbiological contamination in fresh produce no matter where they are grown.
It starts from the farm. There might be contamination from the farm, from the water that is being used by our farmers, and during transportation and even handling. No? Yung mga ano natin, yung mga nagbubuhat, no? And then during displaying of our commodities or produce in the markets, magkakaroon pa rin yung ng chances na may contamination.
Some market vendors and customers, however, are not too concerned about the findings.
Nasa atin na lang talaga kung paano natin lulutuin yun, kung paano natin properly lilinisan.
Hinuhugasan ko po siya ng asin po, tapos niluluto ko po siya ng maayos.
Although most E. coli strains are not harmful, others can cause illnesses such as gastroenteritis, typhoid fever, and dysentery. The BPI stresses that animal manure used as soil fertilizer for vegetables should be properly processed. It is also important to use clean water for irrigation and washing fresh produce, especially vegetables which are eaten raw like lettuce.
We always advise yung mga consumers natin na bago kainin or bago lutuin, we have to make sure na nahuhugasan yun ng maigi.
The Bureau adds, cooking vegetables thoroughly can also help remove any microorganisms present. Easily, ABS-CBN News.
A study shows over 60% of high school teachers in the Philippines are handling subjects outside of their college specializations. As Ara Perez tells us, the Philippine Education Department acknowledges the so-called teacher's mismatch.
Some teachers are not able to practice their major field of study or expertise as they are assigned to handle different subjects. This is the concern raised by some educators during a hearing of the House Committee on Basic Education and Culture.
Halimbawa, sa high school, siyempre may mga subject area yan of specialization.
Correct.
Ang nangyayari kasi ngayon, Mr. Chair, kahit na hindi ka mathematics, ay ina-assign din minsan. So, nagkakaroon tayo ng problema. Yes.
Based on its study, the Second Congressional Commission on Education, or EDCOM2, found that 62% of high school teachers in the Philippines are teaching subjects outside their college specializations. Also, more than half of science teachers do not have a background in the subject.
Yung question nga din po namin is, magfo-focus tayo on science to prepare them for the PISA test that is focused in science, but the data shows that about half of our science teachers, in fact, did not major in science in college, and in physics, 98% did not have a background.
For the private schools, an additional difficulty on our end, because aside from the looking for or recruiting the teachers, one of the problems that we encounter is once we find yung mga teachers na ganito, they transition or migrate to the public school during the school year once there is a posting or a vacancy available. And on our end, Mr. Chair, I think it affects po not just the school itself but our learners ultimately kasi po nawawalan po sila ng teachers in the middle of the school year.
The Philippine Department of Education admits such cases actually happen on the ground.
May mga ganun pong cases.
Yes, bakit nangyari yun?
Wala po tayong enough na math teachers. Maybe not enough from universities or not enough applied for positions in DepEd.
A lawmaker has a number of solutions to address this.
Para makatulong tayo sa kanila, yung sa is really yung expansion ng voucher system. Kasi ngayon, limitado yun, walang grades 1 to 6 eh. Pero again, kulang ng classrooms, kailangan natin ng tulong na yun. Para naman sa DepEd schools natin, ano, sa totoo talaga, I guess, yung pinaka-importante sa akin is ma-decongest natin talaga yung curriculum. Doon tayo sa basics talaga na pangangailangan.
Meanwhile, the DepEd is set to implement a suspension of the regular academic calendar to make way for an 8 to 12 week learning recovery program focused on reading and math. The specific scope and timeline is being finalized by the agency. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine inflation seen to ease in August. The Banco Central ng Pilipinas expects the consumer price index to settle between 3.2 and 4%. That will be lower than the July print of 4.4%. The central bank cites lower domestic oil prices as well as lower rice, fish, and meat prices offsetting higher electricity rates and higher prices of agricultural commodities as the reasons for its lower forecast for August. The official print is due out Thursday next week. An oil price hike awaits motorists on the first week of September. Estimates show kerosene may see the biggest jump of as much as 70 centavos per liter, while gasoline and diesel may increase by 30 centavos. The price hike comes after a big-time oil price rollback this week. Meanwhile, prices of cooking gas also expected to go up next month. Stakeholders expect a kilo of LPG to increase by at least a peso due to geopolitical tensions in the Middle East and a possible rate cut in the U.S. There's no turning back in the massive manhunt for Pastor Apollo Quiboloy. That's according to Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos. Some 2,000 policemen are still searching the Kingdom of Jesus Christ compound in Davao City, believing the pastor is hiding in an underground bunker. Abalos once again urging Quiboloy to surrender and face his charges.
Please naman, nanawagan ako, ito na pananawagan ng lahat. Sumuko ka na. Dahil klaro naman ang sinasabi mo, and you are deemed to be innocent until your guilt is proven in court. Pero may warrant tayo eh. At ang warrant niyan is People of the Philippines versus Apollo Quiboloy. Yung sinasabi mo wala kang kasalanan, may proseso dyan at yan ang korte. Sumuko ka na at harapin mo ako sa susayo.
Members of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ denying the existence of a secret door in the compound's cathedral. The Interior Department said they discovered a secret passageway that leads to Pastor Apollo Quiboloy's room. But the group asserts they are aware of the door since it was used by Quiboloy to access the stage to preach. They once again insist the pastor is not hiding in the KOJC compound.
Information coming from us is not just limited, but also human intelligence and information that also comes from different sources. So, doon po kami rely, and until now, we have reasonable belief that Pastor Quiboloy is still inside the compound.
More or less, nasa around close to 40 to 50% pa lamang yung nai-inspect sa kabuuan. Remember, this is a more than 30 hectares. May mga buildings pa po silang hindi nai-inspect.
Aside from the KOJC compound, the religious group also alleges police personnel have been deployed at the Glory and Prayer Mountains in Davao to find the pastor. Quiboloy is wanted both in the Philippines and in the U.S. for charges of sexual abuse and human trafficking. Dismissed Mayor Alice Go and 35 others tagged in illegal offshore gaming sued for money laundering. Sheila Go, who was initially believed as Alice Go's sister, as well as Lucky South 99 representative Cassandra Ong, were also included in the complaint filed by the National Bureau of Investigation, Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission, and Anti-Money Laundering Council. The charges stem from a probe covering at least 7 billion pesos worth of transactions from Go's bank accounts and assets from 2019 to 2024. Authorities also allege the same people are behind the illegal pogo operations in Bamban, Tarlac, and Porac, Pampanga.
Based on our findings, she is the principal in the money laundering committed in this case. She used several entities in transferring her money. It went to an entity. Ultimately, it ended up with Baofu to pay, among others, electric bills. There was layering. Pinadaan po sa ibang entity bago dumating sa yung sa entity po, yung sa Baofu, na siya rin naman po ang nag-operate ng Zunyuan at saka ng Hongsheng.
Authorities have yet to locate the dismissed mayor. The management of a beach resort in Zambales meanwhile denies Paok's claims Go used their resort as an escape route. It is now considering filing slander charges against Paok spokesperson Winston Casho, who maintains his statements were true.
Never naman siya nagpunta. Wala naman kaming record na nagpunta siya dito.